the time finally arrived that I took delivery of my new 2017 Airstream Interstate Grand Tour EXT with VB air suspension. Today we're at a beautiful South Carolina park on New Year's Eve, and I want to give you guys a quick walk around and tour on the inside. Again, 2017 Airstream Interstate, silver in color. I've got the windshield screen protectors in that come with the Airstream. Airstream, compared to some of the competition, includes every safety feature available on the Sprinter chassis, including the front and rear park sensors, as well as a camera in the windshield for lane keep assist or lane departure. There's also blind spot monitoring as well. Alcoa wheels. What you can't see at night, there's an option or there's a button beneath the passenger side seat that also controls the awning. For 2017, this is a legless awning. It's a foot longer than it was on the 2016. It's about 19 feet long. It now has three support brackets when it's pulled out versus two. But there's an LED light up there. There's also an LED light under the carriage that you can turn on, which is great just for some very low ambient light. Airstream floor mat. Floor mat does not come with the Interstate. This was actually a Christmas present. Surprised that a $20 floor mat does not come included with your $168,000 RV purchase. Rear view or side view monitors, three cameras, one on the rear and one on each side. A little surprised by the install that some of the, it's like a double-sided tape. It's mounted, it's screwed, but then there's also some of that kind of tape that's showing. Side window protector. I'll talk more about those later because they're interesting. Coming around the back, we have your propane connection, your outside power receptacle, new for 2017 is an HDMI input, or output rather. I've yet to figure out why you would, I guess if you want to set a TV out. These are your blind spot sensors. Rear view camera up top. And then we have our shore power, 30 amp connection, your Atwood electric and propane hot water heater, your city connection, your Alcoa dualies on the back. This does have the VB air suspension, and I do have them, the airbags, raised as far as they will, just to help level the vehicle. There's a slight decline here on this camping pad, so it definitely does help. Your macerator pump and hose, your outdoor shower, your macerator valve switches, and your water pump, and your furnace exhaust. Built-in step. And here's the other side view camera. Again, you can see the adhesive. It's almost the foil. There's like a piece of foil or something. I could probably try to push it back behind there. All right. And then you have your chrome-plated step, so you can actually step up and reach the windshield. Let's go in and take a tour. Now, if you guys saw my other video, I introduced you to Spanky. Spanky's with me on this tour. He found the perfect little spot for his bed underneath the desk, which is directly behind the driver's seat. Tell everyone hi, Spank. Spanky, unfortunately, had a little accident the first time we took out the Airstream. He tried to jump from the passenger seat to the driver's seat and broke two of his toes. So you can see he's got a little cast on. So he'll have that on for another few weeks, and then that will finally come off. So coming in, we've got your step, and then there's another step. There are well lights, or aisle lights rather, which are great at night. You have several aisle lights. The screen door is fantastic. Haven't really been able to use that yet since it's still cold here in the southeast, but a full-size screen door. Do not close the main sliding door with the screen door shut. You'll damage the screen door. Fire extinguisher. I've added a couple of rugs in here just to try to protect the floors and also keep the dirt at a minimum. The rugs actually help grab some of the dirt as you enter. Alright, so let me close the door. So to the left of Spanky here is the tabletop, and there are two marine stand, I don't know what you call these things, grommets or floor stands, where you attach the aluminum pole. And then on top of that aluminum pole, you would take this Corian tabletop and use that. So you can actually install it between the driver's side and passenger side seats. I have both seats swiveled around, which is fantastic for whenever you're camping. Let me see if I can back up so you can see a little bit better. It just makes the space a lot more open, having them turned around. Also new for 2017 is the head unit, made by Fusion. Fantastic unit so far. The screen is great. I'm trying to get rid of some of that glare. But that's your home screen. I think it's about an 8-inch screen. Oh, my lights went out. That's what the part of the problem is. You have got your rear view monitor, so as you're driving, that always stays on so you can see behind you, or you can push the button to see the driver's side or passenger side cameras. Here are the window screens. Now, someone can please explain to me if there's a better way to install these, because the instructions for the passenger side and driver side say to put the strap around the safety belt and somehow get it in the window. I can't figure it out. And so the only way I've figured it out so far is by taking these two little straps. It's not much longer than that. You basically have to open the door, get these straps above the door, and slam the door shut so that it will stay suspended like that. Or with the door closed, you can kind of shove the strap up behind the rubber door seal. So I've got to find some way to use Velcro or something, because they're impossible. But what's even more impossible is the front windshield protector. It's a fantastic windshield protector, but it's very rigid, and the only way you can get it in is by manipulating this. You have to turn this a couple of different ways. And see, they have a kind of a wedge here in the actual screen protector. So that wedge allows you to manipulate it around the rearview mirror. And then eventually you can finagle it up on the window. My concern is every time you put it in, you have to keep yanking the rear view monitor around, and I'm afraid that's just going to add unnecessary wear and tear to that. So if somebody knows how in the heck you're supposed to get the windshield screen in, that would be great. Again, overall, it's a great screen or window heat barrier and privacy protector, but besides the side windows and the front window, they're a beast to try to deal with. So I would have hoped for something a little easier to deal with. I definitely like these much better than having fabric curtains. I will take these all day long over fabric curtains, which is another reason why, a small reason why I preferred Airstream compared to the competition. Just a much sleeker RV. Does not stand out and look like an RV. But anyway, so above the passenger and driver side, you've got the storage compartment. I've got my Airstream messenger bag that comes with all the manuals in there. There is a light up here. So there's a frosted plexiglass sliding door. This is a great deep storage compartment. It's easily 2 feet deep and probably 4 feet wide. And then on this side, I've moved it a little bit. This isn't the standard location, but Airstream provides this nice little wood box. There's Velcro on the bottom, so you can actually move it around. I was experimenting with the Apple TV and plugging it into the HDMI switch. There's actually a 4-port HDMI switch, which is great, and a Blu-ray player by Samsung. And then back here is your amplified WineGuard TV signal booster with the little black switch, turn on, turn off. And then this light up here is on high right now, off, that's low, high, and off. And the light actually makes this little button light up, or I should say it's, doesn't make it light up, but it's glow in the dark, so it won't stay lit forever. I'm kind of surprised they didn't make this motion activated, but it's still nice to have. And then when the light is off and you close the plexiglass door, you'll see that it's private enough up there if you're storing stuff. Over here behind this door, you have all your controls. Little hard to see that. Lighting's not that great in there. But your solar controller, your generator, your control system for your power, your 30 amp service, your Atwood heater. It's electric and gas. I have it on electric right now. Your Magnum inverter, and then your battery levels and your tank levels. I love these little knobs. I always thought these actually locked the door when you pushed it in, but it doesn't. So I don't know why it does that. That's kind of, and the reason I found out was from some of the drawers here in the galley. Mr. Spank decided to join us. You can see his little cast. So I had a gallon of drinking water in one of these drawers, and during a curve, the drawer came flying open based on the weight of the gallon of water. Which told me that that little knob did not lock anything. All right, so located directly to the side of the driver's seat is the VB air suspension option, which I chose on my grand tour. This is the remote control. The coil cord is tied directly into beneath the driver's side seat. And I could not get this thing to work
after I took delivery, which I was horrified by. It's a $7,000 option, and I purposefully went out of state to buy my Airstream because of this option. So not only does it improve road handling for passengers in the back, which it makes a dramatic difference, a much smoother ride, it also assists with aerodynamics, fuel efficiency, overall handling, as well as it's just nice having it when you're on a slightly uneven campsite. From front to back, you can raise the rear up. There's no side to side, it's only up and down, pretty straightforward. So what you see now are the indicator lights letting you know that the car is in park and the parking brake is on, allowing you to manually control it. So it's as high up as it's going to go, so it's not going to do anything. If I push down, I can actually hear the air being released. You guys probably can't hear it, but if I push up, I can see the vehicle in the rear raising again, and the air compressor is on. So when you're driving, none of these buttons will illuminate. You cannot manually control the VB air suspension at all. It's in automatic mode. So when you first turn the car on and take the car out of park and release the parking brake, you'll hear the system adjusting itself. The issue that I was having, and I should have showed you, down here on the side of the driver's seat is the fuse box. And the two fuses that are added for the VB air suspension, one controls the compressor, one controls the remote control. The stupid things were loose. And so I was getting intermittent use out of the system. I could not use the remote. None of the lights would work. Even when the system was in park, nothing was working. So come to find out, it's because the fuses were loose. So I basically had to take a very small flathead Phillips or a flathead screwdriver and adjust the prongs inside of the fuse holder, and added some dielectric grease inside, and now it's a much firmer fit and everything's been working fine. But just a big shocker on a $7,000 option that it intermittently works because the fuse box is loose. So I'm glad I was able to assist that. I did write into Airstream as well as VB Air and had very quick responses back from them. So I was very pleased with both Airstream and VB for their quick assistance, as well as my dealer. But any questions on this, definitely let me know. If you ever see a service light or check light, then you know something's definitely wrong. I have not looked to see if I can actually, program without hitting Spank. Sorry, buddy. Yeah. Okay. Well, that just let air out. All right. So apparently I can program those. I need to look into that. Let me fill it back up. All right. That is VB Air. All right. So while Mr. Spanky is down here soaking up the heat from the heater, I'll tell you a little bit about the Grand Tour galley. But first, I'll show you some of the switches. Your main battery disconnect on the left, letting you know that your battery is on. Your tank heaters, your step hold, your patio light, your aisle lights, your dimmer control for your ceiling lights. So all of your ceiling lights are dimmable. Coming down there, and then you can bring them back on. And then I don't know if you could hear or not, the heater just went off. So one of the reasons why I selected the Grand Tour over any of the other floor plans was the massive size of the galley and the additional counter space here. So some of the other floor plans, you really only have enough space for the sink and your stovetop. You don't have all of this countertop.
In addition, you also have it's about a 7 cubic foot total refrigerator and freezer. Refrigerator on the top, freezer on the bottom. You also have this wardrobe pantry, storage closet. Let me try to swing around and open it up. There's honestly so much room in the Grand Tour that I've yet to really figure out where I'm putting everything. So I've just shoved a few things in here right now, but you have your hanging rod up top. There's a light that you manually turn on and off. So if you wanted to take a couple of shelves out, you could actually, from the bottom here to the top, you would have enough room to hang some clothes. Brought my Nespresso Creatista Plus machine by Breville on the road with me. If you're interested, it is a fantastic machine. Check out my other reviews of the Creatista Plus by Breville. It's great to travel with. And then you've got a few drawers here. I've just got some random odds and ends, but they are full extension drawers. Massive hinges on these doors. I mean, these things aren't going anywhere. But just a fantastic storage closet. I originally thought I would use it for clothes, and I've been shoving clothes in the top few storage compartments, and then what I do is actually stand here as you walk in, because you have the most floor space right here by the front door, and this is where I can change, spread my arms, and move around. So this has worked out well. Plus you have the desk area behind that you can put things as you're trying to change. You also have this section of the galley as well with counter space. You've got a massive amount of storage. I won't necessarily go through every single drawer, but the possibilities are limitless. You've got a great residential style flip out cabinet with spun storage. Here you've got a great built-in trash can, paper towel holder, and a little compartment here for trash bags. Sorry, you guys have to see my trash. You've got another drawer down below. And then here you've got three more drawers. You have a built-in, comes with the Airstream silverware drawer. I'm still trying to figure out where to put everything, but the Airstream comes with a massive amount of remote controls. There's another remote control. There's another remote for the screen in the back, which I'll show you. This right here, I found on online. I'll put a link to it. But I have two temperature sensors, one in my refrigerator and one in my freezer. And this way I know exactly what my temperatures are. So refrigerator's at 40, freezer's at 35. I'm not freezing anything right now, so I'm fine with these temperatures. I was actually pretty much using both as a refrigerator. But it's great because you can individually control them. Since the bottom freezer, I want to say it's about 3 cubic feet, if you don't need the full capacity of your 4 cubic foot refrigerator, you could adjust the temperature here, really, and treat it as a refrigerator, and it actually cools much quicker. So if you're in a hurry and trying to get on the road, that's an option for you. Your standard sink with Airstream. I'm not quite sure why Airstream uses this style of sink. I've seen some manufacturers or some RV manufacturers where the faucet lifts this way, which I would actually, I think I would prefer. And this handle is treated a little differently. You have to be very careful to not leave the faucet handle in this up position. What could happen when you close this glass lid, do you hear it? It actually turns the sink on. I have no idea why they've designed it like this. So I think one of the other manufacturers where
the actual faucet itself, it lifts here. I think they've also designed this to be different. I would prefer to have that sink. This sink works fine. As long as you know, you always have to keep this in this position so that when you close the glass, there's no fear of flooding your RV, then you're good to go. Two burner propane cooktop works great. Glass top acts as a backsplash. This little gadget is a foaming soap dispenser that I found online, and I'll put a link to that. It's excellent for the RV because it has a suction cup base. You can take this off of the suction cup base if you need to refill it. And all you do is use regular soap. There's two lines on here. And you fill soap to the first line, and then you fill the container up with water to the second line. Give it a few twirls, and you're good to go. I thought it matched the Airstream perfectly. It's got a good chrome look, which matches the stainless steel and the other finishes in here. And it doesn't go anywhere, so it's always fixed. And I don't have to schmuck around with a soap dispenser. So just a cool little find. Didn't mention, this is the Beechwood interior, which is new and exclusive for 2017. An absolutely beautiful decor. There is the, I think it was the Colombian walnut option, which was the other option I was looking at. But the Beechwood is just a light, bright, it's a medium tone wood, along with the Moon Ultra Leather seats. The Moon color is whiter than the, I think the other color option is Oyster. It's more of an oyster color. It's kind of like an off-white. These are definitely a whiter color. And all of the Ultra Leather trim, all of the panels are a whiter color. You can actually see the shade here. That color, when you have the other interior Ultra Leather, which again I think is Oyster, I can't remember. This isn't the exact color of it, but it matches better. The interior panels actually become this color. So I guess Airstream just didn't want to make the roller shades the same color as the suede here with this color package, but they do kind of stick out a little bit. So while I'm talking about that, let me actually show you. You have this awesome, massive, I don't know why they had to make it so big, remote control for all of your blinds. So you have night shades. Let me try to focus here. Night shades, and then you have sunscreens. So let me just do all of them, and you can individually control every window. So sunscreens during the day will control all of your sunscreens, including up here on the door. So all around the coach, here on the side. So we'll go ahead and roll those up. And the nightshade, go ahead and put those down. Now these are blackout privacy nightshades, absolutely fantastic in the evening. Here you could see the color a little bit better. So it's not exactly the same color as the Magic Suede, whereas the Magic Suede with some of the other color packages more closely matches this. I'm fine with it because the lighter interior, I think, in here definitely helps open up the coach while still looking rich and pretty elegant. All right, so we're not quite in the back yet, but I will show you on the remote control, you have a rear screen button. And if you opted to open your back door, let in a little fresh air, you've got a great massive screen that rolls all the way down to the floor. And I'll go ahead and put that back up. All right, so coming back in the galley again, We left off on this drawer that has the silverware caddy. Here you have a massive pots and pans drawer. I've just got a lot of stuff shoved in there right now. And then you've got another great pots and pans drawer on the bottom. For 2017, you have a new drawer microwave with roasting feature. This was not available in 2016. This is made by Contour. And two ways to open it. You can either select the open button here. You have a nice little shelf for roasting. There is actually a, let's see, heating element. There you go. So that is your heating element for the roast feature. Here's your control panel. And broiler and grill. And that is new for 2017. This is made by Contour. So you can close it by touching the close button, or you can simply just give it a little push and it will close. Same thing with open, if you just give it a little tug. Go ahead and close it. And then when you're driving, first time I drove, I didn't realize it has a little lock and the microwave door came flying open. So you've got a great little lock here. And that just locks in place and keeps your door nice and protected. And then below here, you've got two more drawers. Right now, I've just got a whole bunch of books shoved in that drawer. And then in this drawer, I've got some towels and bathroom accessories. Spank, how's it going? You enjoying your new Airstream? You having a good time? All right. So moving on back, you have this little extension here. I'll show you the galley from the back. So this gives you that much more counter space, and that just locks in place. All Corian countertops, absolutely beautiful color. You have another USB with two USB outlets in it. Now, I didn't realize it with the electric blinds. I think some people have had issues with the electric blinds. I fortunately have not had any issues. I absolutely love them. I've got electric roller shades in my home. They're fantastic. So I'm very pleased with them. And some people have had issues with them, but I read online and I didn't realize it. Without the roller shades, because if we look in here, let's see if we can see. The roller shades, here's your sunscreen, here's your privacy, and they're both, oh, let me get a little closer. Well, this might be a bad one. It's kind of hard. They're on a track, so right here are two tracks. Well, because of that track, you've got, you can kind of see the track right there. So all of this space right here between the trim panel and your screen, you've probably got you're probably 4 inches right there. And you can kind of see here on the outside where they built out the window box. It's not 4 inches, but this little space right here, you're 2 to 3 inches. So, because they had to build out the window frame to accommodate for the track for these blinds, you've got 2 to 3 inches less space on either side of the coach, only back here in the seating area. Somebody mentioned that online. They said they'd rather have manual shades, which I totally get. And they'd rather have their, 2 to 3 inches back on either side. At the end of the day, I think it's perfectly fine back here as far as space goes. Those 2 to 3 inches are not making that big of a difference in any functional space or area that I would really need. The rest of the coach is not impacted by that. So, in addition, because these blinds are built, the tracks are built behind this Magic Suede trim panel, you've got great light protection. And you really don't have any light infiltration
because of how it's constructed. So I think they did a fantastic job, and it's a great feature. Spanky, what you doing? So down here, you've got another aisle light. You have, I think this is your propane gas leak detector. Over here, you've got your circuit breaker box and your battery disconnect. And then over here, you gotta give these suckers a little tug. I've got my Dyson that I've brought along for cleaning, which is fantastic, in an RV. And then behind, you really can't see, is your subwoofer. So both of these chairs, let me do this one. Both of these chairs fold down and then they come together. So this one folds down, comes to about here. This one folds down. Let me show you. All you basically do is lift up and pull it out. All right. So that one's laid out. There are seat belts. This will seat one person. You could really fit two people, but the seat belt's intended for one. And the seat belt's just tucked between that crack there. So if you were to pull this seat down, then they connect here. And then there's a button up here next to the thermostat. And pushing that button will recline your rear sofa. So the rear sofa and these side seats come together. This and this are support brackets that you undo the Velcro. This will lay down. You would take these headrests off. So these will come down to fill in this cargo space back here. And then that gives you that much more space for your pillow. So by the time I'm 6 foot one, by the time I've got my pillow winds up laying about up here on top of the support bracket. So the ultra leather, I know a lot of people think that this is very comfortable. By the time you put everything down, assuming you need a king size space to sleep on, it is very comfortable to sit on. The issue with laying on it are the seams. So you've got this seam right here, which, you know, winds up being right in the middle lower back. And then you've got this massive thing down here. So you've got the metal work here for the hinge of the seat. And then this bolster is here. You can't do anything with it. I know some people have taken it off, but then that's just going to create a bigger void there. This creates a very hard, rigid space when you're laying. And the reason that's there is to protect the hinge. And also fill that space. And when I say protect the hinge, so that the hinge and all the moving mechanism parts aren't exposed. But it just creates, you can see here with it, it's just awkward. And then you have this seam here where your legs are. So, you know, which is fine. You have your two legs, then you've got this thing going across your legs and then your back, your mid back here, you've got a seam and then your head's up there. So what I'm doing when I'm sleeping, I found, let me back up and not run over Spanky. The other thing, if this is laid down together, again, you've got a massive king-size bed, but then it's harder to try to scoot out of bed if you've got to go to the bathroom in the middle of the night. So I found it's actually easier to leave this small little aisleway. I'm keeping one side down, and then I've got about an inch and a half memory foam topper that I'm laying here all the way down. And then I'm just using a sleeping bag, and the sleeping bag actually has, I think it's not but about a half inch, it's just a Coleman sleeping bag, a half inch pad, a memory foam pad in it as well. So I've got a good couple of inches of memory foam to help bridge the gap between all of these little ridges and valleys and brackets and everything. And it has made a tremendous difference.
So I'll put this back up. Again, super simple. And you can adjust it depending on how reclined you'd like it. These pillows are great. They are provided by Airstream. A great durable, dense fabric, and the filling inside is very dense as well. Great custom quality pillow. What's also great is that if you're sitting back here in the rear lounge, you've got, excuse my slippers, you've got a great area to relax your feet. Rear television back here, again, you've got the pull, and then this will come out and you can swivel. Your rear thermostat, air conditioning control, heat control, your two fusion speakers, one on the driver's side and one on the passenger side. And then you have these great adjustable reading lights. So you can swivel those around, on, off. I'm surprised they didn't put a dimmer on these things. They're super bright. So if one person's trying to sleep at night, you've got that on, they're definitely bright. A dimmer would have been nice. Beautiful aluminum work all the way around. Workmanship overall, I've been very happy with. You've got your up lighting above your cabinets. Come back to the back again. You have a drop down. Let me figure out how to do it. There you go. A drop down hanger holder. And there's one on the passenger side and driver's side. You've got your awning style windows. Simply just turn these to open. Get some great ventilation. Your air conditioning. Let me show you the bathroom. So your door handle, simply push to open. It does have a lock on the other side. Now this is a wet bath. And I'm sorry, I don't have a wide-angle lens on. It's a wet bath. It's all one-piece fiberglass, which is fantastic compared to some of the competition that has seams. That was one thing shopping for RVs absolutely drove me insane, was how cheap the fiberglass was in a lot of the showers. You've got a great pull-out microwave, mirror. That is not a microwave in your bathroom. Five-time magnification on the back side. Here you've got your handle for your shower. So this comes out and will be held in there so you can take a shower. Here's a bracket for your clothes. Laundry line, your curtain, it's a fast dry curtain. My towel, let me move that. So new for 2017, this is a, what they call a residential style commode. It's a Dometic, they upgraded it. It's elongated compared to being round, and the flush, the water flush is different than the previous in 2016. So you can see how up top here, that's actually swirling water around each way. So you get a little better water action there. And everything's wet since I took a shower in here earlier and didn't wipe it down. Paper towel holder does a great job keeping the paper towel, or I'm sorry, the toilet paper dry. One thing I have to say in shopping for an RV and in wet baths, they're not my favorite, but for what you get in a Class B, with the exception of the Winnebago Era C that had a great stand-in shower, but then you give up other areas such as a
usable bed without having the slide out. I have to say that the Airstream bath in the Interstate Grand Tour, it's a manageable size. I wish they would eliminate the sink. I really don't use the sink, and if I needed the sink, I come out when I'm changing and standing here up by the main door. Of course, I close the blind, and I use the sink. It just makes more sense. There's more room. I would have gladly given up the sink to have more floor space. So you can see, I mean, it looks like you've got a reasonable amount of space, but let's come in here. All right, so, you know, it looks like I've got room to move. But what you can't see is standing here, how tight you are to the actual sink. And you also can't see how close my arm is to the wall. So if I stand like this, my leg is hitting the edge of the commode, my hip is hitting the edge of the sink. So you gotta kind of shuffle around, and you're either standing like this, or you're standing like this, where your arms are wedged between both walls. Not to mention, you close the door. You know, it's definitely doable, but it's cozy. So I can only imagine getting rid of this whole thing to give you that much space would have been absolutely incredible. Again, I can make do, but I would love to see Airstream come up with something. Now, I've seen a Class B where the sink, I can't remember what manufacturer it was, but the sink was flat against the wall. And it literally just flipped down. It was like a shelf. You used it as a sink. The water drained behind it. And then you flipped it back up. That would be absolutely perfect if you absolutely needed a sink. But all of this can go away. It's a bit much. So I didn't even talk about the standard soap dispenser that Airstream includes. It's at home in my garage. I took it down. It's mounted right here. It's a big chrome thing that has like three little push button pumps, so you can store your soap and shampoo and conditioner and all that good stuff. Well, if you notice, that these were the four screw holes that they put in the fiberglass to mount this thing. Why they didn't use double-sided tape is beyond me, but they went ahead and screwed through the fiberglass. So what happens when you're standing here? You're already super close to the wall, but that thing stuck out of the wall easily 3 inches. So now your elbow is constantly hitting the soap dispenser. So that was one of the first things that I yanked out. It was absolutely insane where it was placed. I mean, good grief, if anything, move it back further, or you have above the commode all of this space. You have this little shelf, which is great, but it needs a little guard on it, or a little rail to keep stuff from falling off. But you have this, which is great. It's just not super functional because stuff moves, but they could have mounted the soap dispenser back here. Come on, guys, what the heck? So I went to Lowe's, I found these plastic plugs in the hardware department. I had to drill the holes out a little bit bigger to fit the plugs. I used a silicone, filled the holes with silicone, and then pushed the plugs in. I'm happy with how it turned out, and now I don't have this awkward, bulky, soap dispenser thing. I did buy some, different types of shelves or soap caddies. I haven't decided on which one yet. Some use a suction cup, some use the adhesive command strips, so I'm still trying to figure out, but I'm gonna put it back here to get it out of the way. You've got two great recessed LEDs. These are fantastic. I've seen some manufacturers where they're actually sticking down. The light fixture is surface mounted. These are recessed, fantastic design. And then you've got your great air vent. So you push up. And I actually need to turn it on to continue to dry out the bath. All right. So I'm gonna close the curtain and let that keep drying out. You've also got a nice little towel bar on the door. Cool little microfiber, very quick dry.
washcloth that I found at the Dollar Tree for a pack of, I think it was like four. These things are fantastic for an RV. And then you've got your little lock here if you ever needed to lock the door. All right, I'm gonna spin right back around. And we did not look at the refrigerator yet. So I think this is about 4 cubic feet up top. You have a great LED light. There's a drip tray up here for when your coil defrosts. A shelf, there's actually another shelf in here that I took out just to make a little more room. And then this is one of the sensors that goes to that temperature control I showed you, and they're numbered, so that's one. And then the one in the freezer is two. And then down below, the freezer does not have a light in it. Not a biggie, would have been nice. And then here's the other temperature control there. And let's go walk around back, and I'll show you the storage in the back. We'll be right back, Spank. All right. I also have to show you the VBR suspension remote. Alright, so big doors, they both lock in place, and then open that, and that locks in. If you wanted to open these all the way, you can actually undo this, and the whole door will fold back onto the side. Storage compartment. I'm using cheater logs because I'm tired of trying to get the campfires lit. Besides, I'm a glamper, not a camper. Got this little tray at Walmart to put my firewood on. VB air suspension takes away the underfloor storage that the non-VB air suspension units have, so you have no underfloor storage here. You do have two great LED lights, one there, they also have manual buttons that you can turn them on and off. And then you can see this support that will fold down. So what happens behind this curtain, I've got my tub of stuff, power cords, water filters, and all of that. Which I didn't mention, if you take this out from inside, you see the doors there that's just below the sofa. You can access whatever you put down here. So there's this aluminum support bracket that rolls out. And then I usually just leave this black on it. And then when these fold down, there's, well, you can't see it. So when they fold down, they just sit right on top of that. And then that extends your bed. And then this is great because, oh, I can't see where it attaches. Oh, here's the little loop. Oh, there it is. Hold on. All right. So this is very similar to, what do they call those things, a tonneau cover? I don't know. Like in a car, in a hatchback or something. It basically just closes off your trunk area and gives a nice cover to it. So you still have a very decent amount of storage space back here. Again, it doesn't look like a lot because this black covers down. But you've got plenty of storage. There, this big plastic container, there's storage there. This is the hot water heater
behind that. And you've got a little pocket storage on either side of the door. You always want to close the driver's side door first. You'll see the opening for the Mercedes logo, and then you want to close this one second. You see how it sticks out? If you were to close this one first and then close this, you'll whack off your logo. Don't want to whack it off.
Thank you guys for watching my video of my new 2017 Airstream Grand Tour EXT. Definitely feel free to let me know if you have any questions or want to see any additional features. When I was shopping for my Grand Tour, I found a lot of salespeople showing them and demonstrating them, but nothing from an actual user. Very, very sparse. So definitely let me know. I'd be more than happy to share with you, and look forward to your comments. Until next time, take care.